Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Now and forever.
There is one body and one spirit.
There is one hope to which we were called. One Lord, one faith, one baptism. One God and Father of all.
Peace be with you.
And also with you.
Beloved in Christ, it's a joy, a privilege to gather here together this afternoon. Give thanks to God for the lives of these amazing candidates who have stepped forward to be counted as members of the body of Christ, the Anglican, United Reformed, and Methodist traditions. So today we're here to celebrate with you, and we thank God for your journey of faith. And as we say in the African proverb, it takes a whole village to raise a child. I want to give thanks and pay tribute to parents and godparents, sponsors, church leaders, Sunday school teachers, priests, curates, and all who have contributed to the spiritual development of these archives. Thank you all very much. But can I remind you that the work starts today. Today, as they stand up to be counted into the membership of the body of Christ, their work of discipleship in Christ starts. So this is when we need to really support them and pray for them and travel together with them on their Christian journeys. And for you, the candidates, this is not the time to say, Mom, I've got the certificate to show for it, and I've got the T-shirt, now church is no longer for me. This is the time to be more serious with your Christian faith. As we shared earlier on, you must let your light shine so clearly and brightly wherever you go, locally, nationally, or internationally, so that light and the name of Jesus Christ will be glorified through your lives. So don't stop coming to church. Don't stop reading your Bible. Don't stop praying. Just from having fellowship. This is the beginning of a journey of real discipleship. And our prayer for you, as you can see, all three of us are here, representing the URC, the Methodist, and the Church of England. Our prayer for you is that you grow up, you continue to be faithful disciples of Jesus Christ in this 21st century. So thank God for your life. And we'll continue to lift you up in our prayers. Welcome to this service. Let's be quiet for a moment of personal reflection. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, by the power of the Holy Spirit, give your faithful people new life in the water of baptism. Guide and strengthen us by the same Spirit, that we who are born again may serve you in faith and love, and grow into the full stature of your Son, Jesus Christ, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
You may be seated for our first Bible.
Thank you. pain in the quivering death, and the young child will put his hand into the vibrant death. They will neither harm nor destroy over any mountain, for the earth will be filled with the knowledge of the Lord, as the waters cover the sea. In that day, the root of Jesse will stand as a banner for the people, the nation and the nation will rise to it, and the resting place will be glorious. This is the word of the Lord.
Pardon? boil the meat and buy cannibal?
Boil the meat and buy cannibal. Well, probably yes, as I said, there's lots of different views of what a missionary is. Hopefully I'm going to just turn that round this afternoon slightly. Okay. Yeah, so do I. When I was growing up in the church that I went to, there was this huge map on the back of the wall of the church with the words that said, "Go ye into all the world." I have to say that I had no idea what that meant. But when I think of the word missionary, for many people as it was a long time ago, it was about people who really, really loved God in some form or way. And perhaps they loved God more than me. They were always up here. I was kind of down here, and they loved God more than me. They're the ones who were on the front line of God's work in the world, willing to give up everything and move to a remote jungle somewhere on the other side of the world, and suffer for Jesus their whole lives. They were classed as the first class Christians in many ways. However, my understanding of that passage in Matthew's Gospel has changed over the years. And here's what I've learned. I think, and I want to suggest to you this afternoon, and including those who were about to confirm, that we are all missionaries. We are all missionaries in God's kingdom. And you and me are involved in the mission of the world. We may do it in very different ways, from our very different traditions, but all of us are involved in God's mission. And that includes those who are being confirmed this afternoon as well. It's not just us who wear our collars the funny way round or wear funny hats. Sorry, Bish. But I think this passage in Matthew's Gospel shows us three things about God's mission, which you and I are part of. First thing is, it's pretty messy. It is messy. Remember, the last thing the disciples knew that Jesus had been executed by the Romans. He was dead. Their hopes and dreams had been crushed and broken. And then it was some women, always at the front, not the men, it was the women, who said the tomb was empty and they had seen Jesus. They had said he was alive and they wanted to meet him on this mountain. So they showed up. And look what happens in that passage. They get to the mountain, it says that some worshipped and some did what? Some doubted. The disciples all worshipped Jesus when they saw him, that post-resurrection that we find on Easter Day, but some doubted. For me, as a Christian for quite a long time, I found great comfort in that, even now, that some doubted. And when we, as followers of Jesus, embrace our doubts, it humbles us up and opens us up to truly listen to others. And I found during my journey of faith that when I have listened to others about their faith journey, no matter how radically different that might be, and for you this afternoon, your faith journey will be different because it's your faith journey. It's not somebody else's. But I learned something new about God. And friends, today your confirmation is not about putting God in a box and tying it up neat in a bowl and saying, "Well, that's that. It's all done." because it is your faith that has led you to this point, and it is your faith that will encounter that resurrected Jesus and grappling with the messiness of the world which you live in. Do not think that because you are being confirmed this afternoon that the messiness of the world will go away. It will not. Our doubts keep us human. It keeps us learning for more understanding. It keeps us engaged in the real world, where the living Christ is in the real world. The second thing I think about this passage, I want to suggest, it's about lifelong learning. Jesus said, if you're going to make disciples, notice that Jesus didn't tell them that they're going to make converts. That is different. He told them to go make learners and followers. And that's what a disciple means. The term convert implies a quick and complete change from one thing to another. Once you were this and now you're that. As a disciple, though, on the other hand, is a person who engages in a learning, in a process of learning, investigating, walking with, and growing. So we can engage in those God-given authentic conversations, where we listen more than we talk. By God, some of us who wear our collars the wrong way around need to learn that lesson, I would suggest. When we listen more than talk, we invite each other to learn more about the way of Jesus. So friends, as you start this new part of your journey of your life through this confirmation, remember, it is not the end. Lifelong learning. It is just about beginning. And it's exciting because you will learn more about yourself and about the living Christ. For each of us, each day, are invited to follow Jesus to the cross and to walk in the resurrection of the power of the Holy Spirit. For this is the life for the world. And then finally, the third thing I think we learn about God's mission in this passage is that we do it together. We're not on our own. Jesus says, teach them to obey all I have commanded you. We might think that that's just another list of rules to follow. It's a test to determine whether we're in or out. Follow the rules and you're in, disobey and you're out. I don't think so. John's Gospel, Jesus commands that we love one another as I have loved you. Love God, love your neighbour, and that's it. The beginning and the end of the law that we must follow. The good news is, friends, is that we aren't left alone to figure it out. Jesus has promised, as we see in the end of that passage in Matthew's Gospel, that he will always be with us. And that means, in the messiness of our lives, in our lifelong learning, and in our friendships as we learn and grow together. So I want to say to you, whatever your image of a missionary is or not, friends, this afternoon, through your confirmation and through your journey of faith, you are a missionary. But let me rephrase that passage as if Jesus was speaking to us right now, today. The whole world is God's, and he invites you to by engaging. Let your walk with God be so natural and that I'm part of your everyday speech, that people will feel free to talk to you and you will feel free to talk about your faith and life on this incredible journey. And so friends, let your confirmation identity today be so real that it splashes on everyone around you as you remember your baptism within this confirmation, so you can flood the world with love and the love of God. The love of God, friends, be in your life, whatever you do and wherever God takes you, and in the things that you do together in this lifelong journey. For we remember, God is with you not only today, as you celebrate your confirmation, but in all that you do. May God bless you. Amen.
Of evil? Do you repent of the sins that separate us from God and neighbour? Do you turn to Christ as Saviour?
I turn to Christ as Saviour.
Do you submit to Christ as your Lord?
I submit to Christ as my Lord.
Do you come to Christ, the way, the truth, and the life? May God, who has given you the desire to follow Christ, give you also the strength to continue on the way. Amen.
Amen.
Friends, I invite the whole congregation to stand up as we confess our faith. Brothers and sisters, I ask you to profess together with these candidates the faith of the Church. Do you believe and trust in God the Father?
I
God has called you by name and made you his own. Confirm all your servant to him with your Holy Spirit. Amen. dear mother, God has called you by name and made you before you. And God knows your servant, dear mother, to your Holy Spirit. Amen. God has called you by name and made you. God has called you by name and made you his boy. Confirm, O Lord, your servant David with your Holy Spirit. Amen. God has called you by name and made you his boy. Confirm, O Lord, your servant David in your Holy Spirit. Amen. God has called you by name and made you his boy. Confirm, O Lord, your servant with your Holy Spirit. Amen. God has called you by name and made you his own. Confirm, O Lord, your servant and I was with your Holy Spirit. Amen. God has called you by name and made you his boy. Confirm, O Lord, your servant's leader with your Holy Spirit. Amen. God has called you by name and made you his own. Confirm, O Lord, your servant with your Holy Spirit. Amen. God has called you by name and made you his own. On the back, O Lord, you are serving heaven with your Holy Spirit. Amen. God has called you by name and made you his own. And cry, O Lord, your servant be ready with your Holy Spirit. Amen. God has called you by name and made you his own. Confirm, O Lord, your servant Abbey with your Holy Spirit. Amen. God has called you by name and made you his own. Confirm all of us your servant's mercy with your Holy Spirit. Amen. God has called you by name and made you his own. Confirm, O Lord, your servant Victoria with your Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you. and maiden is born.
Come, O Lord, your servant Jesus, with your Holy Spirit. Amen.
God has called you by name and made you his fault.
Confirm, O Lord, your servant Jesus with your Holy Spirit.
Amen. God has called you by name and made you his own. Confirm, O Lord, your servant Dorgu with your Holy Spirit. Amen. God has called you by name and made you his voice. Confirm, O Lord, your servant Christ with your Holy Spirit. Amen. God has called you by name and made you his own. Confirm, O Lord, your servant Daniel with your Holy Spirit. Amen. God has called you by name and made you his fault.
And so, O Lord, your servant with your Holy Spirit.
Amen. God has called you by name and made you his own.
Confirm, O Lord, your servant here with your Holy Spirit.
Amen. God has called you by name and made you his own. Confirm, O Lord, your servant that I have with your Holy Spirit. Amen. gentlemen, God has called you by name and made you useful. And Father, Lord, your servant in your Holy Spirit. Amen. God has called you by name and made you his own. Confirm all of your servant son with your Holy Spirit. Amen. God has called you by name and made you his own. Confirm, O Lord, your servant Charles with your Holy Spirit. Amen. God has called you by name and made you his own. Confirm, O Lord, your servant Michel with your Holy Spirit. Amen. God has called me by name and made me his voice. Confirm, O Lord, your servant is my king with your Holy Spirit. Amen. Confirm, O Lord, your servant's blessing with your call you by name, and made you his boy.
Thank you.
give thanks for the Eucharistic bread. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
It is indeed right. It is our duty and our joy. At all times and in all places. We give you thanks and praise. Holy Father, heavenly King, almighty and eternal God, who is Jesus Christ, your Son and our Lord, for he is Lord in you. Through him you have created all things from the beginning and formed us in your own image. Through him you have freed us from slavery of sin, giving him to be born of a woman and to die upon the cross. You raised him from the dead and exalted him to your right hand on high. Through him you have sent upon us your holy and life-giving spirit and made us people of your own possession. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, proclaim your great and glorious name, forever praising you and singing.
Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed
in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna in the highest.
Let our praises, Heavenly Father, to your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. And as we follow his example and obey his command, grant that by the power of your Holy Spirit, his gifts of bread and wine, be to us his body and his blood, who in the same night that he was betrayed, took bread, gave you his thanks, he broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take it. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, after supper, he took the cup, gave you thanks, and gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This cup is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." Yes, Heavenly Father, remember his offering of himself, made once for all upon the cross. Proclaim his mighty resurrection, glorious ascension. We look for the coming of your kingdom. And with this bread and this cup, we make memorial of Christ, your Son, our Lord. Great is the mystery of faith.
Christ has died. Christ has risen. Christ will come again.
Accept through him, our great high priest, this our sacrifice of thanks and praise. And as we eat and drink these holy gifts, in the presence of your divine majesty, renew us by your Holy Spirit. Inspire us with your love. And unite us in the body of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Through him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory be yours, with all who stand before you in heaven and earth. We worship you, Father Almighty. Songs of everlasting.
Blessing and honor and glory and power be yours forever and ever. Amen.
As our Savior taught us, so we pray with confidence.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Jesus is the Lamb of God. Takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those who are called to his side.
Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but you say the word, and I shall be healed.
I'd like to invite all Christian people, whatever denomination you are. If you normally receive everyone in your church, feel free to come forward and share with us, and this can be everything. But if you rather just want to come forward for a blessing, it's the holy copy of the order of service. We know you've just come forward for a blessing.
There'll be 3 points.
Good. Tell us about it.
There'll be 3 communion points. So you'll be pointed to number 3. And those who are distributing, come forward.
Thank you. Jesus Christ,
our high priests who understand all our infirmities, help you to be faithful and obedient.
Amen.
The Holy Spirit who strengthened Christ in the desert, make you strong to resist evil.
Amen.
And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be among you in one place.
Amen.
Go in life
and the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Yeah.
so much for joining me to sing that song with such a heart. And God said, well done. So if anybody tells you that the church is dying out, don't believe it. Because they've been saying that for hundreds of years. The church is still here, and will continue to be here until Jesus comes. You believe that?
Amen.
44 and 43 candidates. This is not the future, this is the present. Just a few thank yous before we take a big group of our candidates. First of all, a big thank you to all the priests and church leaders who prepared these candidates for confirmation. And also the parents. I noticed that some of you have not been focusing or concentrating. But that means that we'll continue to pray more and more for you. That you focus in your discipleship with us. Because you see, God meets with us, irrespective of our age. Samuel was a little young boy. In his early years, when the Lord started appearing and speaking to him. So none of you here is too young, as any of us could say. Because each one of you, as we said today, have been called by name and made to be God's own. So we continue to pray for you. So a big hand to the priests and pastors and elders. Thank you so much. Thank you. Let's also prepare a group photograph with this. One big question before we go to the show.